Hey there, folks. Let's dive into the latest scoop from the world of the royals. Picture this. Like a scene straight out of a drama, the Sussex camp faces another setback as an essential member jumps ship. Yep, you heard it right. Meghan and Harry, despite being somewhat out of the limelight, seem to be losing another key player from their team. Just recently, the Sunday Times dropped a bombshell with a headline that went something like, Harry and Meghan's fifth departure of the year as PR chief exits. Talk about a tough year for Archwell, right? They've been facing quite a few hurdles, and now this. It seems like keeping staff on board is becoming a real challenge for Meghan and Harry. Now here's where things get a bit spicy. This piece of news, just after hitting the stands, vanished into thin air, no explanation given. Makes you wonder, doesn't it? How do Harry and Meghan manage these disappearing acts despite the dwindling buzz around them? Sure, they might not be the talk of the town like before, but they've still got some tricks up their sleeves. Thanks to some eagle-eyed netizens, the article was saved before it got wiped off the internet. So let's get into the nitty-gritty. Ashley Hansen joined the Sussex team in May 2022 as the big boss of media at the Artwa Foundation. For two whole years, she's been the brains behind Meghan and Harry's PR, navigating them through some pretty major events. Since they waved goodbye to royal duties and set up shop in the US in 2020. Remember the launch of Harry's book Fair in January and their Netflix series debut in December that same year? Ashley was the mastermind behind all that buzz. She even handled the PR during the somber times of the late Queen's funeral last September. So you can imagine, her stepping down is a pretty big deal for Team Sussex. So Ashley Hansen, the PR guru for Meghan and Harry, has been steering their ship through some choppy waters for almost 2 years. Despite the couple's knack for stirring up controversy, Ashley's been handling it all like a pro. But here's the latest twist. She's decided to call it quits, making her the fifth senior staff member to exit Team Sussex in just a year. It's like a revolving door over there, with people coming and going in all sorts of roles. It's got everyone wondering, what's up with that? There's talk that Ashley isn't leaving for another gig. Word on the street is that she's looking to spread her wings and dive into the world of freelance. Things with Harry and Meghan haven't exactly been a walk in the park. Despite Ashley's top-notch skills and respect from the team, she's had a tough time because, let's face it, the clients, Harry and Meghan, don't always play by the book. This situation kind of confirms what many suspected. Doing PR for folks who constantly shrug off advice and think they've got all the answers is no easy feat. Imagine trying to guide a couple who's pretty much set on doing things their own way, expertise be damned. It's like trying to sail a boat that insists on steering itself. Ashley, with a solid decade of PR experience, including stints at big names like Universal Film Entertainment Group, NBC Universal Media, and the United Talent Agency, faced quite the challenge. When she joined Meghan and Harry, they started to loosen up a bit with some media matters. What's really interesting here is that, according to the article, it was Ashley who nudged them to reconnect with certain parts of the British press. That's a big deal. Especially considering that post-Megxit in 2020, they were all about cutting ties with the media. Remember the days when Meghan and Harry wouldn't even pick up the phone for British press? Well, under Ashley Hansen's guidance, there was a shift. They started playing nice with certain media outlets. Take the Invictus Games, for example. There was this WhatsApp group where tabloid journalists got the inside scoop on everything from Meghan's fashion choices to the fact that she did her own hair and makeup. It's like Ashley was trying to bridge a gap, realizing that to keep the spotlight on them, they needed the British press, not just the US media. But let's zoom out for a second. In less than 4 years since they moved stateside, Meghan and Harry have had a bit of a revolving door when it comes to their staff. Before Ashley, there was Toya Holness, who was their head of communications for a brief stint from July 2021 to May 2022. She had quite the journey, starting as their press secretary and then moving up, only to leave for greener pastures. And let's not forget Christine Shermer, who jumped ship from Pinterest to join the Sussexes. With all these exits, you've got to wonder what's going on behind those closed doors. Despite Meghan and Harry's efforts to keep things looking rosy, the constant departures tell a different story. Just this year, there were two more significant exits: Ben Browning from Archwell Productions and Farrah Taylor, who was leading their marketing team. When they left, Ashley Hansen was all praises, saying they exceeded expectations and left a mark on the cultural zeitgeist. Sounds a lot like Meghan's style, doesn't it? Trying to put a positive spin on things when the reality seems a bit more complicated. The skepticism is hard to shake off. It's clear that they've had some top-tier professionals on their team, but keeping them around, that's a whole other story. So let's unpack this a bit more. Meghan and Harry, they're big names, sure, but when it comes to the nitty-gritty of their respective fields, they're not exactly seasoned pros. This seems to be a key reason behind the parade of professionals bidding adieu to their team. Imagine the tightrope walk for someone like a producer, trying to meet Meghan's unique demands while keeping their own reputation intact. Take Mandana Diani, for instance. An Iranian-born activist and entrepreneur, she was a top aide at Archwell. But less than 18 months into the job, right around the release of Harry and Meghan's documentary series first trailer, she decided to step down. Ashley Hansen called it a mutual decision, with the Sussexes taking the reins of their company. But between you and me, there's probably more to that story. The trailer itself stirred the pot, featuring misleading footage implying Harry and Meghan were hounded by the media at events they didn't even attend. Remember the Harry Potter premiere footage? They weren't there, but the trailer suggested otherwise. You've got to wonder if Diani tried to steer them away from such content, only to hit a wall and decide to protect her own reputation instead. And there's Rebecca Sinanis, who left her gig as the head of audio at Archwell in the same month. She was the one working with Meghan on the Archetypes podcast series. Her departure sparked some chatter. Could it be that she had doubts about the project's success? Maybe she saw the writing on the wall about the challenges and potential underperformance of the podcast and thought it best to step back. It seems like these professionals like Sinanis, with all their experience, are choosing to distance themselves from the Sussex camp. It's a tough scene, balancing high-profile clients with personal professional standards. The Sussexes might have the star power, but keeping seasoned experts on board? That's proving to be a royal challenge. The saga continues with Rebecca Sinanis making her exit from the company, seemingly disillusioned with the content she witnessed. Her decision doesn't seem too far-fetched, especially in the aftermath of Spotify cutting ties with Harry and Meghan back in June. This split became more pronounced when Bill Simmons, Spotify's head honcho for podcast innovation and monetization, didn't hold back his thoughts on a podcast. In his words, "I wish I had been involved in the Meghan and Harry Spotify negotiation. The effing grifters. That's the podcast. We should have launched with them. I have got to get drunk one night and tell the story of the Zoom I had with Harry to try and help him with a podcast idea. It's one of my best stories. F them, the grifters." Talk about not mincing words. Then there's the revelation of Harry's podcast ideas. Picture this. Interviewing big guns like Trump and Putin about their childhood trauma, and even the Pope, though the reasons behind that one are a bit hazy. These plans seem a bit out there, don't they? This could be a glimpse into why Meghan and Harry are hitting roadblocks in creating engaging content. Their ideas might be ambitious, but maybe not exactly in tune with what audiences are looking for. Back in April 2020, Harry and Meghan brought on Catherine St. Laurent from the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation as their chief of staff and executive director at Archwell. But fast forward to the next March and she's out, perhaps overwhelmed by the challenges of working with the couple. This year has been a roller coaster for Harry and Meghan, peaking with their appearance on The Hollywood Reporter's Biggest Losers of 2023 list. Ouch, the report took jabs at their Netflix documentary, biography, and podcast, painting the Harry and Meghan brand as a sanctimonious bubble on the verge of popping. Can you imagine Meghan's reaction to that? It's clear that maintaining a successful public image in the midst of all this is no walk in the park for the Sussex duo. Imagine Meghan's reaction to all this tumult. It's enough to stir up quite the image, isn't it? But wait, there's more. Even South Park couldn't resist taking a jab at Harry and Meghan. They were hilariously portrayed as the Prince and Princess of Canada, embarking on a worldwide privacy tour. This episode wasn't just a hit for laughs. It struck a chord with many viewers, possibly even swaying public opinion and contributing to a dip in their popularity. And then there's Family Guy, adding its own twist to the narrative. In one episode, Harry and Meghan are baffled by a mysterious Netflix check, poking fun at the seemingly odd dynamics surrounding the couple. These shows have a knack for spotlighting the absurdities of public figures, and it seems they've cast a revealing light on the Sussexes. Amidst all this, a story about a dramatic car chase through Manhattan's streets emerged. Ashley Hansen, still with Team Sussex at the time, released a statement about a paparazzi pursuit that bordered on catastrophic. But here's where it gets interesting. Photographers and the NYPD offered a different take, suggesting the situation wasn't as dire as claimed. Even the taxi driver who was part of this chase downplayed the incident. All this drama might shed some light on why Ashley Hansen decided to part ways with Archwell. Dealing with Harry and Meghan's high expectations and challenging demeanor seems to have been a recurring theme for their employees. It begs the question, can Harry and Meghan attract and keep experienced professionals given this pattern of dissatisfaction? Now, let's pivot to something a bit more interactive. We've got viewer comments rolling in on the video titled, "Still on the Naughty List." Sussexes want to see King Charles for Boxing Day, but we'll get a big snub. The posed question is, so let's tap into the pulse of public opinion on whether there's any chance of Harry and Meghan making a comeback. Viewer Donna Duffy isn't holding back, suggesting that the British public won't easily forget the accusations and statements made by the Sussexes. According to Donna, the British aren't the type to let go of such significant allegations. This points to a real challenge for Meghan and Harry. Can they really expect people to just move on from past controversies? Then we have Diane weighing in, firmly believing that the UK will never welcome Harry and Meghan back. She's of the opinion that it's up to Charles to address this issue, or else the people might take matters into their own hands. Diane's comment echoes a sentiment of strong resistance to the idea of the couple's return. She goes as far as saying, "I would prefer to witness the end of the monarchy than see Harry and Meghan being rewarded for their actions." That's a powerful statement, underscoring the depth of the public's frustration. Diane doesn't mince words about King Charles either, calling him weak and foolish for not dealing with the situation head-on. There's a growing perception that Charles has been too lenient with the couple and has even allegedly lied and covered up for the Markles. This frustration is mounting, with calls for Charles to step down if he can't maintain neutrality and refrain from making what some view as preachy statements. It's clear that many in the UK share Diane's disappointment and are looking for King Charles to take a more decisive stand. The suggestion is that he shouldn't pass the buck to Prince William, but rather address the issue himself. This feedback from viewers paints a picture of a public that is deeply divided and vocal about the ongoing saga of Harry and Meghan and their place within or outside the royal family. And that wraps up our dive into the latest twists and turns in the world of Harry and Meghan. Thanks for tuning in and joining this discussion. Keep an eye out for more updates and insights in our upcoming videos. Have a fantastic day.